Well, my story starts when I was 9 years old. I was in Iran, and my dad was in prison for 6 years. And I couldn't see him in my childhood, and I just saw him once a month, maybe only 15 minutes behind the windows. And it was just, you know, hard for a kid to not see his her dad at that age. And everybody was like, making fun of me and saying, oh, you don't have dad, you don't have anybody to protect you. Mm-hmm. But my dad, when he was in prison, he saw Jesus in his dream. And he said that I will set you free if you repent. Mm. And my dad didn't know what to do, and he didn't know what is repent means. And he went and asked a lot of people what does it mean and what is this dream about. Because he didn't believe in God. He said, my God is my own power, and my own power is my God. So he didn't believe in God.
ولا حتى بالتعليم الإسلامي.
He hated Islam, actually, because his dad is a sheikh. And from the age five, when he was 5 years old, his dad pushed him to do Islamic rules. And he hated because he saw that in his family, his dad says he preaches about Islam and says, like, you know, do these things, but he doesn't do it in their home.
يعني كان الوعظ أو التقل يعني التعليم بالكلام فقط ولكن ليس بالسلوك في الحياة.
Yes, yes. That's why he hated Islam. And when he was 12 years old, his dad said, you have to obey my rules or otherwise I'm going to ask you to leave the house. Okay. And he left their house in the age of 12.
Okay.
He grew up in the streets, and he had like bad life. He almost sleep in streets every day.
بأي عمر فريناز عرفتي أنت أنه بيك تحول من الإسلام إلى المسيحية وكيف عرفتي؟
On that time I didn't know until we went to Turkey.
كنتوا yes. مضطرين أنه تتركوا إيران وتروحوا على تركيا.
Yes. My story actually starts from here that we moved from the city that we were to my dad's own city. And over there, suddenly, one day I saw that I don't have any control in my body. And I wanted to do something, but I couldn't. After a week, my mom noticed that something's wrong.
Okay.
Because I couldn't hold spoon, I couldn't sleep, because I couldn't control thinking or writing, or I couldn't control my hands. It was just moving, and I didn't want to. If I wanted to walk, I couldn't, because I didn't have control in my legs. The way I wanted to go or walk, I couldn't, because I just didn't have control.
شو عملتوا بريناز بالنسبة لهذه الحالة؟
It was really hard because my friends saw me like that. And all my family, they thought that I'm just doing these things because I want more attention, or I'm just being, you know, I just need attention. But it wasn't like that. We went to doctor after a month. I couldn't even walk, and my dad was carrying me.
Okay.
We went to doctor, and doctor said, oh, and sometimes I had really, in my heart, I had pain.
Okay.
Each time I was breathing, I had pain in my heart. So we went to doctor, and doctor said, because you had sore throat, the infection got into your body because you didn't take care and you didn't have medicine. So the infection got all to my body, and from infection, the veins from my heart to my brain was closed. And that's why I couldn't control. I didn't have any control from my brain. My disease, my problems didn't stop because I didn't have any medicine. And after that, it was going worse by the time. On that time, my dad found a church, a Turkish church, and we started to go to church with my dad, me and my dad. My mom was against. My mom was always against Christianity, and she said, I lost everything. I'm not going to lose my religion.
هل خبرك بيك انه هو صار مسيحي؟
He did. He told us that I saw Jesus, Jesus set me free, and I want to follow him. And my mom said, no, if you do this, I will divorce you because this is the last thing you can do.
بالنسبة لك انت بريناز, شو كانت ردة فعلك؟ شو فهمتي من الموضوع؟
The first time that my dad said that, actually, I was happy because I saw a change in my dad. My dad always was like hard. He wouldn't smile. He wouldn't, you know, care too much. But he was changed. He would smile. He would just love.
كل بنت بتحب تشوف هيدا التغيير ببيا من القسوة إلى الحنية.
Yes, yes. That's true.
رحتي على الكنيسة مع بيك.
Yes, we went to church, and the moment I went to church, I entered, I felt peace, and it was different. Outside of church, everybody was looking at me as a girl, paralyzed girl. That can't move, can't do anything, and it's just piece of meat sitting there.
هل كنتي مشلولي؟
I was paralyzed because later on, doctor diagnosed me as MS. So I had MS too, and MS was starting from my legs, going up, and actually half of my body was paralyzed, right side of my body, and I couldn't move. My dad always had to carry me. So in the church, I felt someone. I felt that somebody's nice to me, somebody cares about me. They would come and just pray for me. They would show love to me. But outside, they were just making fun of me.
هل قصدتي إنه المسيحيين المؤمنين داخل الكنيسة كانوا عم بيعملوكي بمحبة بينما المسلمين خارج الكنيسة كانوا قصاط عليكي؟
Yes, there was a big difference between Muslim and Christianity.
كيف ممكن لبنت عمرها 14 سنة تفكر بهيدا الوقت لما بتشوف الفرق بين يعني يلي منسميه الكنيسة وتصرفات الناس داخل الكنيسة وتصرفات ناس خارج الكنيسة ما بينتموا للكنيسة.
See, at the age of 14, when you're a teenager, you need more attention. And I didn't have that outside of church. They were just making fun of me, and it really broke my heart. Because I was active, I was always, I always wanted to, you know, be active, but I couldn't. And I wanted to spend time with my brother. I have a younger brother, but I couldn't. I wanted to go out and just have fun, but I couldn't. And I wasn't. I was not like other teenagers. So, but in the church, even I was paralyzed and I couldn't do those things, but I had peace and I had freedom in my heart. That, and I felt so happy because people, they were just nice to me and they were playing with me. They pray for me. It was just different.
وقت تحكي بيرناز عن حرية القلب أو حرية في داخل القلب شو قصدك بهذا الشيء؟ يعني بنت 14 سنة شو بتفهم من موضوع حرية القلب؟
Freedom of heart, it's like you want to do something, you have dream, but you can't because of your physical problems.
Right.
But when you have freedom in your heart, it's a different because even you know you can't do it, but you have peace, you have hope that one day it will happen. It's just the belief that gives you the freedom.
Okay.
When you believe, when you hope, you have hope, it gives you the freedom.
الكنيسة عم بتعاملك بمحبة. لوين وصل هيدا الموضوع؟
There was a family in church that they said, we are going to take care of your medical expenses and we're taking you to the doctor. And when we went to the doctor, the doctor said, because of the MS, we can't do anything. But for your heart, we can put you for the surgery and we can at least help you breathe normally without pain. But there is a, like from 100%, there is only 10% that you can live after the surgery. Because I was so skinny and those drugs that they wanted to give me to put me in sleep for the surgery, it was so strong. And if they gave me that medicines, the drugs, I couldn't wake up from that surgery.
شو كان القرار؟
My dad said, I will do anything. We pray, but at the same time, I will do anything because I don't want to look back and say, what if I did? So they got all tests. They gave me the time for surgery. And they said, after a month, you have to come for the surgery day. And in a month, one day from church, a couple of people, they came to our house and they prayed over me for 4 hours. And after 4 hours, they left. And on that time, my mom wasn't a believer. My mom, but she always prayed that if I see a miracle, I will believe. And that miracle has to relate it to my daughter because that's the only thing I have. She's the only thing in my life that I have. So they came, they prayed, they left. And on that night, I prayed. I said, before I go to sleep, I said, Jesus, I love you, and I know if I die, I will be with you, and even if I don't die, I will live for you. So I don't care if you heal me. I just want it because of my mom, because I want my mom to see the miracle. And I fell asleep.
شو هالصلاة يعني الحلوة مو يعني لبنت بعمرك صلاة كتير مميزة هل فعلا يعني انت ما كنتيش مهتمة كتير بشفائك قد ما انت كنتي مهتمة انه امك تعرف الرب كمخلص
Yes, because As I said, I knew that even if I die, I will go to Jesus. Mm. So I just wanted for my mom. I said, I want her to see the miracle and believe in you. So do it for my mom. And then I fell asleep and I saw a dream on that night. I was laying on a bed and the room was white, and suddenly a man walks in with white and shiny face. He came and said, do you want to get healed? I said, I don't know. Go ask Jesus. And he said, no, I'm asking you, do you want to get healed? I said, yes, because I have pain. And my life is just hard for me. I want to get healed. Mm. And he said, okay then, be healed. And he gave me a cross on my hand. He put a cross on my hand and left. In the morning when I wake up, I was screaming. I was so happy. And I called my dad. Because I couldn't move from bed. So I called my dad. I said, I saw this dream. And it was the day that we were going to do the last tests for the surgery. And my dad said, praise God. And we prayed together. And my mom was like, yeah, mm-hmm. You know.
All skeptic.
Making fun. Yes, dreams.
I'm checking with the topic.
So, we went to doctor that day, and the doctor said, I see the results, but let's do it again. Mm. Let's test again. On that day, they tested me 3 times. And when doctor saw the test results, he said, what did you do? Asked my dad, what did you do to this girl? And my dad said, we didn't do anything. And he said, whatever you did, keep doing it. Because I see the results right now. And the results from the last one, it says that this girl, even with the surgery, wouldn't leave. But now, the last one says, her heart is just like a newborn baby, and all of the disease that she had, it's gone. Mm-hmm. And even her MS, when we tested, mm-hmm. there is a difference. So there is a hope.
I mean,
for the MS. And on that time, when my mom was with us, and when she heard that, she just bowed on her knees and said, I believe in Jesus.
Perinaz, يعني في سؤال ملح لازم اسألك اياه واكيد كثير من المشاهدين يلي عم يتابعونا اليوم عم يطرحوا هيدا السؤال بينهم وبين نفسهم، انه ما فينا نعتبرك انه انت متحوله من الاسلام الى المسيحيه، يعني انت جئتي تقريبا من فراغ، والدك هو بنفسه ترك البيت المسلم وهو عمره 12 سنه، قلتي انت انه عايش في الشارع، وبالتالي انت ما تلقيتي ولا اي تعاليم اسلاميه، هل بامكانك انه تعتبري نفسك انت يعني متحوله من الاسلام الى المسيحيه؟
People think that when they born and a family, let's say Christian or Muslim, they are one of those, mm. them. But I believe when a child is born, doesn't have any religion until he or she decides. Mm. So I don't think that I was Muslim, but I was coming from Muslim background mm. until I received Jesus. I actually read Quran. When I was in school, I was going to Quran courses mm-hmm. and taking classes about Islam. And I also read the Bible. And when I compare them, I see the difference. I see miracles. I see lots of change that when you compare them from Islam to Christianity, you see the difference. And our Jesus died and rose again. But I don't want to believe in someone who is dead. And I don't want to believe to the words that dead person says. I wanted to believe to someone who is alive every day, is with me. So I can't believe in someone who is dead and tells me I will have eternal life.